Hello, Out Entrepreneurs. Rhodes Perry here, and welcome to episode number 34 of The Out Entrepreneur, a weekly podcast where I get to interview today's most inspiring LGBTQ bosses crushing it in business. So on today's show, we have Tracey Minutolo joining us all the way from sunny Southern California, San Diego, to be specific. So Tracey, are you ready to inspire fellow out bosses?
Yes, I am.
Great. Well, I'm really, really excited to have you on the show. A little bit about Tracey. Tracey is a side hustle coach who helps motivate 9-to-5ers launch and grow profitable side businesses that they're passionate about. When she's not coaching, she's probably playing with microorganisms at her day job, checking out the latest craft beer release, or hanging out in the San Diego sunshine. So craft beer, we definitely share that in common. And I'm really psyched to have you on the show, Tracey. Tell us a little bit more about your business and what makes it unique.
Sure. So as you mentioned, I am a side hustle coach. So I help 9-to-5ers like myself basically design and launch side businesses that fit within their lifestyle and will help them to reach their goals. So it's really critical to kind of spend a lot of time upfront to make sure that we find a side hustle that's going to be a good match. So many people kind of dive in right away and end up getting burned out or finding out that, you know, what they wanted to do isn't actually as much fun as they thought it would be. So that's, I guess that's one thing that kind of sets me apart. But the other thing is really just that I don't bash on day jobs. I have a day job. A lot of people out there have day jobs. And we also have an interest in kind of dabbling in this entrepreneurial world. So if you look online and you look everywhere, there's a lot of kind of day job bashing that kind of goes on. Everybody's kind of interested in screwing the 9-to-5. But I think that if we all screwed the 9-to-5, the world would look a lot different. And I'm not sure that would be the best thing. I think that, you know, there's definitely a place in the world for employees and entrepreneurs, actually. So I think that sets me apart a little bit from folks in my space.
Yeah, I love what you're saying about not bashing the 9-to-5ers, right? It's a both and kind of world. And not everybody is wired to be an entrepreneur. And I think the what you're doing is really, really valuable in carving out that space of saying, okay, you know, you have this idea, or I can help you kind of get really specific on this idea for a side hustle or a side business. And you get to test it out before really taking that leap of faith, right? Which can feel really, really scary for a lot of folks that aren't quite sure if entrepreneurship is for them. So, you know, you're doing a lot. You're working with microorganisms during the day, and you're running this business on the side. So right now in your business and helping other folks think about, you know, their side hustles, what's one thing that has you most inspired today?
Well, I think the most inspiring thing for me is watching other folks who are coming from the 9-to-5 world just have that moment where they realize, like, I can really do this. I can really earn income outside of my paycheck. And this is just amazing because it just, and speaking for myself as well, I mean, it just gives you a new sense of just freedom, independence, possibility. So being able to help facilitate that for other people is just awesome.
Yeah, I often talk about, well, I'm going to give credit to Laverne Cox, who talks a lot about possibility models. And I think what you're showing for the 9-to-5ers is that there is this whole other world. And you're showing those possibilities and really inspiring folks. So in thinking about your business, your side hustle, I often talk with entrepreneurs, and these are folks kind of, they've dove in and they're doing this full time, about thinking about that moment when they had that business idea. And usually what I find is that they start pursuing their businesses for one of two reasons. And the first is that they truly felt a calling, they felt the purpose, and they wanted to align their life with that purpose. And the second is that some have felt that they were tired of trying to conform and fit into a business culture that didn't value all parts of who they are. And I'm curious, you know, recognizing that you're still kind of in the 9-to-5 world, but on the business side, you know, as you were creating this business and as you were motivated to show other folks the possibilities of side businesses and entrepreneurship, which one of those two scenarios resonates the most with you and why?
With me personally, it's probably the second one, even though I do love my day job and I've had some great jobs in my career. You know, I'm about 20 years into my career as well, so I have a long track record and all in microbiology. So I love what I do, but I recognize that that isn't the only thing or the only thing that I'm capable of doing. It's not all of who I am. So I was definitely yearning for some opportunities to do some things that were kind of in the back of my mind as possibilities, kind of giving that a shot out there too. And so not, I guess the way that I think about it is that your day job can kind of fulfill one aspect of your purpose, or one can kind of give you, I guess, some, let's see, how do I say it? It just, it basically will fulfill some needs for you, but your side hustle can be a passion project where it actually speaks to another aspect of your purpose and your desire to make a mark on the world.
I think that's great, that distinction of showing, you know, the value that a 9-to-5 job can bring, especially that consistent paycheck to really fuel
right.
the other side, you know, as you're pursuing a purpose-driven business, something that is aligning fully with who you are. And also showing, like you said, that there's freedom available in pursuing that side hustle. And on the topic of workplace culture, because you have felt some urgency of conforming to a workplace culture that where you may have to cover certain parts of who you are just to fit into the dominant culture of the workplace, I'm curious, what's one thing that you do in your side business that really indicates to folks who may feel othered or may feel different that they're welcome and encouraged to work with you?
That's a great question. Well, I think one of the things I do is I talk about day jobs. So I know to go back to that again, but I do, because I think there's a lot of, not everywhere, and I shouldn't generalize, but I know how I felt and how I still kind of feel in some circles that, you know, if you are happy in your day job and you are feeling that it does provide something beyond just a paycheck for you, maybe it's development opportunity, maybe it's just the structure of having, you know, that 8-to-5 and kind of having that, you know, in your life. It could be a number of things, but I feel like it's a little bit taboo in some circles to talk about that in that way. I mean, we should all be kind of grinding to get away from that, right? Actually, just reminds me of a post I put up in my group yesterday. I had a member who was excited about a new job that he may be getting. He's waiting to get a call back. And I'm like, well, it was buried down in a comment thread somewhere. And it was just kind of like an offhanded comment. But I pulled it up and I said, hey, you know, just so you guys know, this is a safe space. We can talk about jobs here. This is part of who we are, and I want everybody to feel safe and included. And I wasn't sure what kind of response I was going to get, but I got a lot of really positive responses back. People were like, thank you so much. I needed to see that. So I guess that's one way.
Yeah, just acknowledging that people are at different places in their path to creating their own side businesses, and just to acknowledge some of the struggle that comes along with that. And I think that you're lifting up some of those struggles without glossing them over, right? And I think
right.
that's really helpful for the folks that you're working with. So definitely an awesome coach to recognize
yeah.
that. Yeah.
That and also the wins, you know, I mean, you might be excited because you got a promotion at work. I think it's cool to share that in a side hustlers group. I mean,
yes.
I think that's awesome, you know, and we should be allowed to celebrate those things.
Yeah. Yes, definitely. So shifting gears a bit, because the show is about the being the out entrepreneur, I'm curious, did being LGBTQ influence your journey to start your side hustle, side coaching business?
I think it's influenced my journey overall. I think, you know, I came out when I was 19. I realized that I was gay a little bit before that, probably just a little bit before that. You know, those college years, they can do a lot for you. But since that point, I realized that I was definitely different and I was carving my own path in a lot of ways. I just wasn't maybe aware of all of the ways that I was doing that, where I just wasn't conforming and to what was necessarily expected of me. So I guess I've had a long time kind of in that mindset to where it was like, you know what? I've already kind of pushed aside a lot of sort of expectations and, you know, norms in a lot of ways. So why don't I just do what I want to do in a lot of areas of my life? So I really did take a pretty traditional career path, but I think the side business thing really speaks to why just do the day job? Why not start something else? Why not? I guess that's kind of been with me for a long time.
I love that. Why not? Right? It's just,
yeah.
It's all kind of an experiment, and having that curiosity is such an important trait to being an entrepreneur of testing and changing. So take us back and share a time when it was pretty challenging to be out in your business. And this could be a moment where you were either afraid of losing business or you may have felt unsafe. And sharing your story is really important for our listeners, because many people are thinking about taking that leap or interested in the services that you provide and starting that side hustle. and really struggling with thinking about how out should I be in this business? Should I be out? Can I be 100% out, or will that impact the bottom line? So can you think of a situation where it was difficult? And if so, what were some ways that you worked around that?
Yeah. And so I just mentioned to you before we got on the interview here that it really hasn't been, I guess, at the forefront of my mind as something that I would draw attention to. And I think it's just because it's just so much of, you know, who I am. I don't really think about it very much. I just think I'm Tracey and that's it. And I also happen to have a girlfriend and, you know, cool. So I think being on this show, I mean, this is the first time I'm on a show that actually is explicitly out. And so for me, it's really exciting. And I think I don't have fear in the back of my mind, but I'm just kind of wondering how folks are going to receive that. Because maybe, you know, I'm not shy about it. I'm open about having a girlfriend. I talk about her all the time in podcast interviews and in my group and, you know, with my business folks. So it's not really a secret, but it's not something that I put a spotlight on. So I'm really kind of interested in, you know, to see kind of what happens out there. I guess to your question about, you know, how would I be getting through that if there are any fears? I think it's also just the benefit of being a side hustler too, that it's not, the income from this is not paying my bills necessarily. This is like it's a passion of mine and it's a side thing. So I guess it's not like a huge fear, but it's more of a curiosity to see how the world receives me. I think for the most part, it's been fine. And I don't know, when this interview goes out, I'm excited to see.
That's great. And I liked what you said about on the perception piece of not being fearful, but just being aware that other people may have a different perception, you know, of being accepting, or that's in the back of your mind, that level of self-awareness. And I think that that's a strength of being within the rainbow family, as I often say. And, you know, this show is all about empowerment. And I really want listeners to understand the strengths that we have, especially when we can apply them into our business. And I'm curious from your perspective, and I may be pushing you because I'm kind of encouraging you to reflect on how your identity shows up in your business mm-hmm. and at work. You know, what are some strengths because of the, you know, the unique experience of just, you had mentioned coming out at 19, right? Where not everybody has that experience of having to tell other people in the world who you are, truly are, and being self-actualized at such a young age. So can you think of maybe one or two strengths, or as a good friend of mine says, the gifts of being LGBT? Do you know, one or two of those gifts come to mind to you?
Yeah, well, as a coach, I think it definitely comes through, because, you know, my whole philosophy is just be who you are out in the world, be open about it, and the people that resonate with you and the people that really get you will definitely raise their hand and say, I want some of that. Like, I want to align with you. I want to be part of this. And the ones that don't, they will go away. And if, you know, there is some backlash or some, you know, everybody's going to have haters at some point. If you're in business and you're out, even if you're not gay, you're going to have people that don't agree with your message or just don't like you.
Right.
So that's normal. But I think, you know, it's especially nowadays, I think in the online business space, there's a lot of areas that are very crowded and it can be hard to stand out. And the only way to differentiate yourself really from other folks that are providing a similar service or product is really just to be yourself, because that's where the difference is. I mean, that's kind of what, you know, makes you unique. It's you. So that is something that really it comes through very strongly in my coaching. And I encourage people to be open, you know, and to post about their business on their Facebook page and talk about it with their friends and family and show people what they're up to. Put the personality in there, because that's really what's going to get them the results. So that's probably the biggest thing, is really just kind of my philosophy really just bleeds through into my coaching. And I gently, but I definitely push folks to kind of, I challenge their fears around showing who they really are and then get them to get out there.
And building off of that, because I think the kind of that underlying thread of being yourself is so key, considering some of the challenges and, like you said, just kind of the current political and cultural climate that we're in right now, it depends where you live, right? Mm-hmm. But being in this country and around the world, it can be somewhat scary to be out. I want you to kind of think about those ups and downs and share with us, you know, one thing that you want our listeners to focus in on to make sure that they can be themselves and to walk away being inspired to have a little more spring in their step to be authentic at work?
Well, I think it's just obviously, and you mentioned, you alluded to this, that, you know, it's, there's a gift that that we have that is basically this heightened awareness of our surroundings and kind of maybe taking measured risk, if that makes sense, kind of looking at where you are and what's out there and what you feel is safe and what's not safe. And especially as a woman, I think I feel it even more so. But I think that that's probably the best thing. It's really just to look at what, you know, the risk is and what the reward is, and make that calculation for yourself and take the amount of risk that feels doable, that you can do, and then test the waters, see how it goes. And, you know, I think I happen to be pretty lucky in terms of my workplace, and maybe it is a function of being in San Diego, but, you know, there's a lot of folks that are out at work and where I'm at, but it hasn't always been that way. So I think it's just a matter of kind of adjusting to your surroundings, but definitely kind of testing the waters and seeing what you can do. And because every time you put yourself out there, that sends a message to other people that, hey, there are gay people around us. We kind of need to pay attention. We can't ignore the fact that, you know what I mean? We can't. So I think visibility is really, really important.
Yeah, visibility is huge. And I really loved what you were saying about take that measured, calculated risk. And I think that's especially important as you're still in a 9-to-5 job of testing the waters. Maybe go up to your ankles and see if that works. And if it feels good, keep going. And as you're testing the waters with your business idea, also test the waters of being more out if that's not where you're at right now, and see how people receive that. And if that feels good, continue with it. And if not, adjust. And I think really, really solid advice. So thank you for sharing that.
Yeah.
One additional question before we take a quick sponsorship break. You know, what's one thing that you do in your company right now that gives back to LGBT communities?
Oh, wow. Well, this wasn't necessarily in my company, but I have a lot of volunteer experience here in San Diego. And so actually, it's what led to my first side hustle. We had an annual fundraiser event that raised money for at-risk homeless and LGBT teens in San Diego. And we raised over $40,000 for local organizations here. So volunteering and just kind of being a part of things and seeing where I can help has always been a part of me.
That's huge. And I really loved what you said, that this kind of level of volunteerism led to your first business idea. So can you explain just that connection? Because I think some folks might be curious about that.
Yeah, absolutely. Because a lot of us, when we're looking for side business ideas, we're looking at what we've been paid to do in the past. So this was a blind spot for me. So I did social media and promotions for the event that I was just mentioning, but I also was helping another organization that worked directly with homeless teens, basically with their website, their social media. And so I became sort of a little bit of an expert in social media at the time. And because I was the only one who wanted to take on that responsibility. So I took the ball and I ran with it. And so that actually was the skill set that I turned to when I wanted to start my first side business, which was providing virtual support services for podcasters.
That's brilliant. And I think for folks that have a business idea and are worried that they don't have specific skill sets, follow Tracey's lead. Think about ways that you can volunteer in your community and then gain those skills that you need to build that business. And in Tracey's case, it's gaining social media skills, it's gaining skills to be present online, and then turning that into your side business. So thank you for sharing that, Tracey.
Yeah, absolutely.
Really, really helpful. And so we're going to take a very quick sponsorship break. And for our listeners, please stick around, because when we return, we're going to learn just a little bit more about Tracey and her business.
HR and diversity professionals, are you struggling with engaging LGBTQ talent? Do you stay awake at night worrying about limiting litigation risks? Have you considered seeking support around these concerns, but just aren't sure where to turn? Look no further. Rhodes Perry Consulting offers you solutions with the Engaging LGBTQ Talent A to Z certification. This proven 4-week mentorship program delivers skills, offers support, and connects you with other professionals committed to transforming themselves and their workplaces. Learn more about this cutting-edge program by visiting rhodesperry.com. and use the promo code RPC for a 10% discount. Take action and visit rhodesperry.com.
Welcome back, Outbosses. We are now going into our bonus round, where we'll have the chance to get to know Tracey a little bit better, gain some insights on how we can bring our whole selves to work, and then learn one way to stay in touch with Tracey after today's conversation. Tracey, are you ready for some quick-fire questions?
Ready.
Awesome. Okay, so in one sentence, what does it mean to bring your whole self to work?
It means to be working in your strengths and to be authentic and to be sharing your gifts with the folks that you come in contact with.
I love it. And if folks haven't read Strength Finders, really basic, but really, really helpful. And kind of going back to our strengths as a community of being self-actualized, it's just another tool to help you really understand how to leverage your natural strengths, your natural gifts, as Tracey was saying. What's one personal habit that helps you master yourself and your business?
Probably the biggest habit would be just getting up early. I know we talked about this before the interview, but I'm up every day between 5 and 5:30 in the morning, and my first hour is what I call me time. So I'm there, I'm reading, or I'm meditating, or I'm just staring into space and kind of collecting my thoughts. And if it were not for that time, I don't think I'd be able to accomplish everything that I do.
Yeah, 100%. And I'm very impressed that you're getting up at 5 a.m. I try. And what I'd say is there's actually a book called The Miracle Morning. And I'm not sure if you've read that, but it's underscores a lot of what Tracey just shared right now. And there is something magical about those early morning hours where the emails aren't necessarily coming in at quick fire pace, and it allows you to really be clear about where you want to go in your day. So if you can try it, especially for the night owls, if that works, you know, or if you just test and change, just try it once and see how you feel, or maybe, maybe give it a week.
Okay. Yeah.
Name one thing that you readily delegate in your business to stay focused on what you're good at.
Ooh, that's a good question. I am a solopreneur, so I am not delegating anything yet at this time. I am looking to put together, basically to refine my business processes now, put those together, put some SOPs together, standard operating procedures, and then at some point in the future, I'll be ready to hire like a VA.
Yeah, and for solopreneurs, I'm in the boat as well. Being really clear and intimate on all of the aspects of your business is key in order to explain it to those folks that you'll eventually hire or contract out to. And as Tracey was saying, those standard operating procedures, you know, writing at least a one pager on different systems within your business, while it may seem like extra work in the future, especially if you want to scale your business, it's one of the most valuable exercises that you can do. So Tracey, can you share a book or a podcast that has contributed to your success as a boss?
I know this is probably, this may have come up before on the show. The show's been around for a while, but The Side Hustle Show, just awesome. Nick Loper is rad, and just listening to that show kind of opened my eyes to the possibilities. I mean, he interviews people that were just like me. They were doing all sorts of cool things, and that really helped to light the spark for me.
Yeah, that's a great resource. The Side Hustle Show, and I'll include that in the show notes. Another good show and a book that's coming out is Chris Guillebeau, who has the Side Hustle School. And the thing that I like about that show is it's 8 minutes, so it's really, really short. And it's just little things that you should think about in your business. And he's a cool guy. He's also in Portland, Oregon, and runs the World Domination Summit. So if you're, it's another valuable community of folks just either thinking about getting their businesses started or went the route of the side hustle, and just really inspiring people. So Tracey, thank you for being on the show. Before we go, can you share one piece of advice to inspire the next generation of outbosses to take that first entrepreneurial leap?
I say, if you're interested in something, if there's an idea out there, a business that you would like to start, go and find somebody who's doing that or doing something very similar and talk to them about it. Get the information and then take what you learn and get moving.
Yeah, great advice. And definitely mentorship and people that are where you want to be 5, 10, 20 years from now, definitely make those connections. And I found in my own journey that people are really open, at least the folks that I've been fortunate enough to speak with, and willing to share. So thank you for sharing that advice. So again, Tracey, thanks again for being on the show and for inspiring fellow outbosses. Can you share one way that we can stay in touch with you and learn a little bit more about your business?
Absolutely. Probably the best way to stay in touch with me and keep tabs on everything I have going on, including upcoming coaching programs. I actually will be setting up a group program pretty shortly, would be the Side Hustlers Haven, my Facebook group. So you can either go to Facebook and search Side Hustlers Haven, or you can go to sidehustlershaven.com and it'll take you right there.
Great. And I just noticed on your website, you have your first profitable side business idea, and it's a 5-day mini course.
That's right.
For listeners who are just thinking about getting started, definitely reach out to Tracey. She's phenomenal, a great resource, an awesome coach, and you should definitely make that connection. So again, thanks Tracey for being on the show. For Outbosses, thank you so much for tuning into this week's episode. As always, it's my privilege to connect with you and so many inspiring Outbosses like Tracey. And as a next step, check out the show notes for highlights from today's conversation, subscribe to the podcast, and consider leaving a rating and review in iTunes. And for now, keep being your authentic selves 100% of the time.